السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهدي ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أوصي وأوصيكم بتقوى الله قال تعالى وجوه يومئذ ناظرة إلى ربها ناظرة أما when the عبد is experiencing sakarat al-maut and is preparing to transition from this life to the next. The Prophet ﷺ has conveyed to us that if the abd is salih, righteous, that the heavens open up and an army of malaika descend. And they are wearing beautiful clothes, their faces radiant and white and smiling. There's thieb, misk, good smell that descends. And Malik al-Maut appears. And Malik al-Maut greets the abd, the soul, and says, Ukhriji, come out. Come out, ila rahmat rabbik. Come to the rahmah of your Lord. And come to his ridwan. And that abd that has spent a life of giving for the sake of Allah, that Abdul spent that life in offering prayers for the sake of Allah, offering time for the sake of Allah, offering its food and its water, giving up its food and its water and its time for Allah. That Abd then, who has spent that life giving everything easily for Allah, that Abd gives itself to Allah. And it gives itself easily. And the ruh comes out with such ease and gentleness. And the malaika carry it through all samawat to meet Rabbuna Jalla Jalaluhu. But if that abd was not righteous, then an army of malaika descend and they bring with it a very uncomfortable garment from Jahannam. And their faces are not bright, their faces are stern. And they say to the nafs, come out to the displeasure and the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that soul which is used to not giving for Allah, that soul which is used to withholding from Allah, that nafs that is used to turning away from Allah, that nafs that is used to forgetting Allah, does not want to meet Allah. And it holds itself back. And Malak al-Maut pulls, and it pulls back. And he pulls, and it pulls back. But Malak al-Maut is mightier than the ruh. And so he drags the ruh kicking and screaming. And the nafs, which is attached to every nerve, every cell in our body, it doesn't want to give itself up. And that extraction becomes painful for that abd. The garment of Jahannam is placed on that abd. Just like when you go to prison, you get the prison clothes. And that abd is taken away. This is the options that we have. Allah Ta'ala blames us in the Quran for coming from Jannah but wanting the world. And we are people that have focused on the world too much. We are people that are created in haste and we prefer immediate gratification to delayed gratification. And Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, كَلَّا بَلْ تُحِبُّونَ الْعَاجِلَةِ. You love this world, you love it. وَتَذَرُونَ الْآخِرَةِ. And because of your love for dunya, you abandon the work of the akhirah. You don't do it right. Some people don't do it, others don't do it right. And others don't take it seriously. And so because you don't do it right or you don't take it seriously, it's as if you've given it up or you've left it. And then he says, there'll be two types of appearances. وُجُوهُمْ يَوْمَ إِذًا نَاظِرًا. Some of the faces on that day will be bright and radiant. إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَاظِرًا. And those faces will be gazing at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fixed on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, staring at the ultimate prize, tabaraka wa ta'ala. وَالْوُجُوهُ يَوْمَئِذٍ بَاسِرًا. But then there's other faces on that day that are gloomy, depressed, sad, darkened, black. سَذُنُّ أَن يُفْعَلُ بِهَا فَاقِرًا. Because they know that what is about to happen is going to be a calamity. They know a disaster is coming. They know that what is coming is going to be the worst thing ever. And so they're depressed. Kalla. Allah Ta'ala gives us a very powerful final statement on this issue. Who do you want to be? Because that time will come to every one of us. Everything has an end. And so what are you working for? When the ruh, Allah Ta'ala says, بَلَغَتِ التَّرَاكِ, when it meets the collarbone, when that ruh, when the malaika are extracting that ruh and it reaches the collarbone, it's right there. When it's being taken out, it leaves from the feet, it's being extracted, it's being pulled from the legs, then it's being pulled out more, the ruh exits from the stomach, it's being pulled out more and it exits from the chest, it's being pulled out more and it exits, and it gets to right here at the collarbone. Taraki. When it's right there, right at the brink of death. وَقِيلَ مَنْ رَاق. It will be said at that time, who will, man, who will rock? One of the most profound ayahs in the Quran, in my opinion. Who will do rock? Rock is like a, has two meanings, two shades, like a coin with two sides. So one is a statement from the human being around the dead person, around the dying person, at the time of death, when death is about to happen. Those people around the deceased person will say, Man Raq? Who will do Raq? Raq bimana ruqya. Who's going to help him? Who's going to save him? What medicine is there to cure him or her? Who's got the ruqya? Man Raq? Who's going to keep him here with us? Allah Ta'ala says in another part of the Quran, tarji'unaha. As the ruh is coming out, you've got all this medical technology and this, all this clothing and devices and this, that, and the other. Tarji'unaha in kuntum sadiqeen. You don't believe in this affair? Return it. When it's right there, Allah Ta'ala said, I've got this ruh. This is my property. This is mine. I'm bringing it to me. You thought you owned your son? I don't think so. You thought you owned your daughter? Who do you think you are? You think you're in this world by yourself? This is mine. If it's yours, take it back. If you're truly working for this dunya, you don't believe in me, return it. Man Raq, who's got the medicine for this illness? Called melt. Raqeela Man Raq, who's going to bring it back? And while the human beings are wondering, where's the medicine, where's the cure for this? How can we keep him here? The malaika are also saying, Man Raq. Who's going to do Raq? But the Raq that the Malaika are talking about is different. It's not about medicine, it's not about Ruqya. Man Raq from the Malaika that are standing there grabbing that soul, they're wondering who's going to do Taraki. Taraki is to bring it up, not bring it back. Who's going to take the soul? Malaika to Rahma will be there. And Malaika to Nar will be there. And they'll be having conversation. Who's going to take this soul? Is it the Jannah angels or the Hellfire angels? Man Raq. Let's look at the documentation here. Abdullah, nice name. What did he do? Was he at the masjid? Yeah, it looked like he was at the masjid. Pay his zakat, looks like it's all done. Is his salat finished? Well, it appeared to be there. He treated his wife well. Well, she was kind of happy with him. Children abused? Not really. Looks like he's okay. We've got him. Malaika Rahma. We've got him. He's coming with us. Man Raq. We've got Abdul Rahman here. Wonderful name. Salat here? Not really. Zakat here? No, he was kind of selfish, actually. How did he treat his wife? She complained every day about him. His kids, they never did anything for him. He never did anything for them. Man Raq. Malaika to Nar, take him away. Who's going to carry him? The angels of the hellfire say, I got this. We've got it. For some of them, Malaika Rahman will take the ruh. And Malaika to Nar, the angels of Nar, will say, no, 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 no. Yes, we understand your documentation says he's people of Jannah, but we've got a transfer order here. He's been transferred. On the surface, yeah, he was at the masjid, but his qalb was in the mall. On the surface, he paid, but his qalb was there. He did it so people could say he paid. He gave to the masjid, but in reality, he gave so people could say he's generous. He didn't do anything for Allah, he did it for him. We got a transfer order here. Look, signed. Rabbul Alameen. Transfer. Jannah to Nar. He's got to spend some time here first. 50,000 years in Nar first. After he's barbecued and cooked for a bit, then you can have it. Man, walk. Where are you going? Who's going to take you? Whose hands do you want to be in? Malaika of Jannah? Of Rahmah? Who do you like to be transferred to? That's the question. Or Malaika to Nar? This is Quran. Not making this up. Baqeela man walk. Who's going to take him? And at that time, وَظَنَّ أَنَّهُ فِرَاقُ. People know, and he knows, his family knows, everyone around him knows, he's gone. At that point, he's gone. Nowhere, no other option. You've got one life, one chance, one opportunity. You've got to make the best of it. And so he's lived his life, she's done her work, she's gone now. He's gone now. Done. Put a khatam, seal on the life. وَالْتَفَّتِ السَّاقُ بِالسَّاقُ. And at that time, at that ending, his saq, his leg, will be brought together with his other leg. Couple of meanings. One is a reference to the janazah. The legs will be bound together. Another meaning is that التفت الساق بالساق, he'll have, as this ruh is coming out, the alim of the ghayb, the world of the unseen will be lifted. That veil will be raised from his eyes or her eyes. And it will be like one leg is in ghayb, one in dunya. He'll look at one leg and it'll be in the ghayb, in the unseen. Because he's going in that direction. And he'll look back and the other leg will be in dunya. So before him is ghayb, the unseen, the malaika he's going out, he'll look back, behind him is the world. So he looks at one leg, he looks forward and he looks at the other. He looks back. Goodbye. Goodbye. This is where I'm going. It's like when you walk, one leg in front of the other. The other ma'ana is deeper. Saq means violence. Violence. Hardship. The Arabs say in the Arabic language, Al-harbu ala saq. The war became saq, became violent. That reference is for the angels that strip out that ruh that doesn't want to come. إِلْتَفَّتِ السَّاقُ بِخْسَاقُ, which means that when the malaika meet him, when they look at him, when they face him with violence, with hardship. That soul that doesn't want to meet Allah, they get tough with it. They wrap themselves around it and they pull saq بِخْسَاقُ, violence with violence, hardship with hardship. Toughness with toughness. They get tough. And they yank the soul out. They rip it out. No, your Lord has called you, you come. Your Lord has ordered you, you move. You didn't want to take the command in dunya, so now the command it takes you in akhirah. Come on, get over here. Your Lord says, march, you march. Move. And he took the soul. Who do we want to be? إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ يَوْمَئِذِ الْمَسَاقِ. Your destination. The malaika will say, where are you going? You thought you were going to work? You thought you were going to school? You thought you were going to college? You thought you were going home? Your destination is your Rabb. Where are you going? Fa'ina tadhhabun. Where are you going? Where do you think you're going? You've got all these other destinations in dunya that cloud your understanding of where your final destination is. إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ يَوْمَئِذٍ الْمَسْحَاقِ. You're going, your destination is Rabb. It's like you've got the GPS in the phone. GPS guides you when you get to your destination, say you have arrived. You'll know it in your nafs when you've arrived. You don't need GPS. So who do we want to be? Can a Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on Laylatul Isra, he said, Ra'aytu Sidratul Muntaha. I saw the Sidratul Muntaha on the night of Isra. And then he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ra'aytu Arba'atu Anhar. And I saw four rivers. Four Anhar, four rivers. He said, one of them is a river of water, and another is a river of milk, and a third is a river of wine, and the fourth is a river of honey. And then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he conveyed to us, he said that inna fil jannah, in Jannah, there's a bahar, there's an ocean of water. And then he said, there's a bahar, there's an ocean of milk. And then he said, there's a bahar, there's an ocean of wine. And then he said, there's a bahar, there's an ocean of honey. And from this bihar, from these oceans, these four oceans, water, milk, wine, honey, from those four rivers emerge from those four oceans. And then he said, he said, in front of the Bab, in front of the Bab of Jannah, there is another river. It's called Baraq, with a qaf, not a calf. And he said, that river, it flows in front of the Bab of Jannah. And by that river, there is a kubba, a dome, that is green. Just like the masjid here has a green dome. And he said, under that green dome are the shuhada. The shuhada. They sit by the river, under that green dome, in front of the Bab of Jannah. And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that they are yurziqoon. They are provided with rizq by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Can you imagine that? Sitting in front of Jannah. There's Jannah, there's a door right there, Bab al-Salam. There's a door right there. There's this river. He said, Ahlul Jannah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, when they enter Jannah, the first thing that they will be offered is an ard. He said, an ard. Okay, not a piece. He said, an ard, an earth of bread, of khubs. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then they will have a thawr, a piece of what we would consider today steak, meat. And he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, also said a piece of kebed from hoot, piece of the liver from a large fish, and a drink from salsabil. Salsabil, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when you drink from salsabil, hadith. When you drink from salsabil, all of the hiqt, all of the malice and anger and hatred and all of the darkness, the bad memories, the depression, the sadness, the hurt, the pain, the anger that we all remember and experience in dunya, all of that in one sip disappears. From salsabil. All of that is gone. Cleansed, you're cleansed of those bad memories. They're purged. And then you take a second sip, and he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that light emerges from your bodies. It becomes radiant. The limbs, the body parts become light. The arms, the legs become light. And then the face, yudhi wujuhuhum, the face becomes illuminated. And Ahlul Jannah will have radiant faces because of that. Wujuhun yawma idhin nadira. Their face is light, Allah Ta'ala said. Illuminated. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ahlul Jannah will gather together on Jum'ah, on Friday. And on Jum'ah, there will be a rih, a gentle breeze that flows. And Ahlul Jannah who gather in these areas in Jum'ah, they will take a whiff and feel that breeze. And that breeze will transform their garments and transform their bodies. And they will go home refreshed, renewed, looking more beautiful than before. He said their appearances of Ahlul Jannah will be the beauty and the height of Adam alayhi salam, because Adam was created alayhi salam directly by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what can be more beautiful than the khalq that has been created directly by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The feet of the people of Jannah will be pure from the wudu that they've made. There's no Nikes in Jannah. You walk bare feet. And your feet are pure because of the washing in the wudu. The people of Jannah will have made wudu and wiped their heads, and that will give their heads the ability to wear crowns in Jannah. The wudu that the people of Jannah will have performed in dunya, it was washed their mouth, they rinsed their nose, they washed their ears. And so in Jannah, because they purified their ears in dunya in Jannah, they will hear nothing but salaman salama. No lies, no lahu, no bad news, nothing. They purified their mouths, so their mouths will speak only good. Their food and their drink and their garments and their closeness and intimacy that they'll experience will not be because of need, only because of pleasure. So they'll eat more because it makes them feel good and they get more pleasure, not because they're hungry. They'll drink more, not because they're thirsty, but because Allah wants them to have more pleasure and enjoy more. The wine of Jannah does not intoxicate, but it is pure. It does not cause headaches, but gives more light. The bowls and the spoons and the dishes that they eat from will be from gold and silver. Allah, the Prophet ﷺ told the companions, لا تشربوا في الآنية الذهب والفضة ولا تأكلوا في السحافها فإنها لهم في الدنيا ولكم في الآخرة. Do not eat from gold or silver containers, and do not drink from gold or silver containers, because those things are for them, meaning the disbelievers, in this life, and they are for you in the akhirah. And so you hold off. Ahl Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will address them in the middle of all this comfort and luxury. Ya ibadi, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that Allah will call out, O my slaves. And they will turn to Him and say, Labbaik Allah. We are here at your service, Allah. All hamd belongs to you, Allah. And Rabbuna Jalla Jalala will say, are you not pleased and content with my promise? And shall I increase you more? And the ibad will say, Ya Rabb, what can be more pleasurable What can be more joyful? What can be better than what we already have? And Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala will grant Ahlul Jannah the most beautiful reward of all. And that is the reward of seeing Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. The ultimate reward in Jannah. And those people in Jannah will be gazing at Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَاظِرًا Looking at their Rabb. Sahabas said, Ya Rasulullah, will we really see Allah in Jannah? And the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, you will see Allah in Jannah just as clearly as you see the full moon in the darkest of the night. Just as clearly. But Ahlul Nar will be mahjubun. They will be veiled from the beautiful vision of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. And so we spend a lot of time in this dunya looking. We spend a lot of time in this world searching. We spend a lot of time in this world toiling, striving, moving, growing, doing all kinds of things. But we must ask ourselves, as we say salam to this Jumu'ah, the last Jumu'ah in Ramadan, the last of all the Mubarak days in Ramadan, because Jumu'ah is the most Mubarak day. And the Jumu'ah in Ramadan is the most Mubarak of all Jumu'ahs. And so we must reflect and make a commitment to ourselves. Who do we want to be? What kind of ending do we want? What type of welcoming do we want? And keep that in our mind. And with that decision, put it in the forefront of our mind, not the back. Because with the end of Jumu'ah and the end of Ramadan comes Shaytan. And his job is to make sure that we sit with him in his gathering in the hellfire. His job is to make sure that all of our gains this Ramadan are for nothing. His task is to make sure that everything we strove so hard for these past 30 days almost, everything we sweat for, everything we gave up, everything we sacrificed, everything we tried to give, that all of that is for nothing. And he doesn't sleep. And he doesn't eat. And he doesn't take a vacation. He works 24/7 to bring us down. This is an enemy that is no joke. And so we must not get complacent. When we are tired, we must lift each other up. When we slack, we must lift each other up. We must strive harder. We must strive to be together. We must remind each other of who we are and what we must do. And we must pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala constantly for tawfiq and success. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst those who see and who gaze upon his Mubarak face. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather us under the banner of La ilaha illallah Muhammadan Rasulullah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to do amal salih and to do amal in the right way for the right reason. Bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أوصي وأوصيكم بتقوى الله قال تعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم اهدنا في من هديت وعافنا في من عافيت وتولنا في من توليت وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت وقنا شر ما قضيت إنك تقضي ولا يقضى عليك إنه لا يضل من واليت ولا يعز من عاديت تباركت ربنا وتعاليت فلك الحمد على ما قضيت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك نستغفرك ونتوب إليك نستغفرك ونتوب إليك وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم رب اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين عباد الله اتقوا الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون أقم الصلاة.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadar Rasulullah, ashhadu anna Muhammadar Rasulullah. Hayya 'ala salah, hayya 'ala salah, hayya 'ala al-falah, hayya 'ala al-falah. Qad qamatis salah, qad qamatis salah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah.
La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Shoulder to shoulder, heels on the line. Please fill in the gaps. Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين قل اللهم مالك الملك مالك الملك تؤتي الملك من تشاء وتنزع الملك ممن تشاء ممن تشاء وتعز من تشاء وتذل من تشاء بيدك الخير إنك على كل شيء قدير تولج الليل في النهار وتولج النهار في الليل وتخرج الحي من الميت وتخرج الميت من الحي وترزق من تشاء بغير حساب الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين قد أفلح المؤمنون الذين هم في صلاتهم خاشعون والذين هم عن اللغو معرضون والذين هم للزكاة فاعلون والذين هم لفروجهم حافظون إلا على أزواجهم أو ما ملكت أيمانهم فإنهم غير ملومين فمن ابتغى وراء ذلك فأولئك هم العادون والذين هم لأماناتهم وعهدهم راعون والذين هم على صلواتهم يحافظون أولئك هم الوارثون الذين يرثون الفردوس الذين يرثون الفردوس هم فيها خالدون الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. A few announcements, inshallah. First, we have some dua requests, inshallah. Abdul Hamid Khan.